ministry, preaching. How did it get started on ministering? I started reading, the Lord took me right to Ezekiel chapter 3. And I started reading that, you know what, if I don't go and warn the wicked, that their blood's on my hands. Yeah. The first verses that I ever read in the Bible that I actually understood what the Bible said and what it meant. Yeah. And I said, I got to start telling someone about Jesus. Yeah. I got to start warning them. You know what? You're going to die and go to hell. That's what's going to happen to you. I don't care if you're on the high life. I don't care if you're down low. It doesn't matter. You die without Christ, you're going to go to hell. Yeah. That's what's coming for you. The guy had some sort of Christian upbringing in his life. And at the end of the CD, there was a song there, and he opened up that song by saying, "What shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and yet lose his own soul?"
Yeah.
Well, those are the words of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ.
Right.
So there I am in the morning, and after I would run every morning, and I'm hearing this at the end, "What shall it profit a man to gain the whole world and yet lose his own soul?"
Wow.
And so when God convicted me that night, it was those words that rang out in my mind and in my heart.
Yeah.
"What shall it profit a man to gain the world and yet lose his own soul?" Mm-hmm. And I knew I'm that man. I'm trying to gain the world and I'm going to die and go to hell.
Yeah.
And I cried out to Jesus, "Lord, I need you. Save me. Clean my life. Do whatever you want to do with me. I'm yours, Lord. I surrender." I left there. I got up the next morning. I didn't know what happened that night. I just cried out to God. But I woke up the next morning, same CD in the car, and I heard all the stuff. I got it out. I broke it. I threw it on the floor.
What?
Yeah, I went to the Christian bookstore, and I went and bought a Bible.
Yeah.
I need to read the Word of God. And we get into how did the street preaching, how did it get started on ministering. I started reading. The Lord took me right to Ezekiel chapter 3. And I started reading that, you know what, if I don't go and warn the wicked, that their blood's on my hands.
Yeah.
The first verses that I ever read in the Bible that I actually understood what the Bible said and what it meant.
Yeah.
And I said, I got to start telling someone about Jesus.
Yeah.
I got to start warning them, you know what, you're going to die and go to hell. That's what's going to happen to you. I don't care if you're on the high life. I don't care if you're down low. It doesn't matter. You die without Christ, you're going to go to hell.
That's
what's coming for you.
That's
I started just trying to minister to people, trying to talk to people, and there came all the people trying to come out and say, "Hey, you know, you need to calm down a little bit, or you need to, you know, just relax a little bit."
Yeah.
And the church I was going to was liberal and watered down. I didn't know that at the time.
Right.
But whenever I got saved, I knew, man, these guys are telling people to come to the Lord for a better life and better. They need to get saved so they don't go to hell. That's why I need to get saved.
Amen.
You know, I'm asking these people, "Hey, why are you saved?" "Well, I need to quit smoking cigarettes."
Yeah.
You need to get saved so you don't die and go to hell. That's why.
Yeah.
And so I started ministering, things like that. Finally, God just threw me out, said, "Hey, you need to go somewhere else and do that." Started going out on the streets, giving out tracts, ministering to people, and ended up coming. And this was before all the YouTube. I didn't even have a computer, so I didn't even know that. And so, but as it started coming together, I started seeing some videos, and I typed in, I was looking for everything. I think the first street preacher website I found was like the Street Preachers Fellowship or something. And I seen a picture of Brother Reuben on there. And I'm looking, and he's holding up a huge, I mean, it was one of the banners that you said. It was, just a huge banner, and had fire on it and everything. And I was like, now that's going out there saying something and doing something. So I started reading all the stuff, checking it out, ended up getting to YouTube videos and seeing some actual street preaching on YouTube and seeing it being done and hearing the preaching. And I was like, this is the page I'm on.
Yeah.
And this is the page I want to stay on. And these guys are on that page.
And so,
praise the Lord. It just all took off from there. In that time, my brother had gotten saved. We were going out on the streets preaching to people, and the message was warning the people of the wrath to come.
Yeah.
Right. You know, just as John the Baptist said, "Who hath warned you to flee from the wrath to come?"
Right.
And so the message hasn't changed. It's going on 11 years this February that I've been saved, and the message hasn't changed.
Amen.
Turn to Jesus or burn in hell. You need Jesus. Why? So you don't die and go to hell. That's why.
Right. That's why.
And
that's
right. And so,
amen.
You know, that's my testimony. I thank the Lord for saving me and doing the work in my life. And praise God.
Praise God. Amen. Amen. God is going to use a lot of different people, a lot of different backgrounds, a lot of different testimonies. Of course, most of you know mine. I always give credit to my parents and what they did, their upbringing.
Catholic.
And oftentimes, you know, you are training your children to live holy and righteous.
Yeah.
And I'm fruit of that. You don't need a testimony of drugs and alcohol.
Amen.
And I'm very thankful that that happened.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm very thankful that I can have pressures and problems in my life. Very seldom will you hear me complain. I got the same financial problems, health issues, car breaks down, you know, before I leave. I got the same problems. I just don't air it out. And so when I have these problems, I don't reach for a cigarette.
Yeah,
I don't think about, well, I like a drink.
That's right.
I sure like to shoot some heroin in my vein. I'm very thankful I don't have that wiring that that my parents did. And so when you raise your kids properly, they may not understand it, but I'm very thankful that I didn't bite that apple. And oftentimes when people see me on Facebook, oh, this guy obviously got saved in prison. Look at the way he looks. Little do they know. You know, you talked about your parents sitting around at a table. Our dining room table was a marketplace for thought. We were allowed to talk about anything. And so, you know, we grew up with that. You didn't eat with a little TV tray in front of the TV. You sat down, you ate, everybody talked. That's the way I grew up. And so it was a very good thing, good wiring. We still do that today. And so what a blessing. And so my testimony is a little bit different. And you're going to hear different people's testimony. And so again, I'm very thankful for my parents to raise me, that I don't, in my everyday pressures of life and problems, that I don't go for a cigarette. I don't go for, I wonder what a drink's like. And so God bless those that did. Doesn't mean that you're better off. And like I said, I've given the testimony before. Some of the places that we go preach, it helps not to bite that apple. You know, sometimes music can hinder a man. When we're out on Bourbon Street, brother, I, you know, that music is a jarring, a memory of what I used to do when I was a kid, and what I used to be involved in. Can we just go down the street? You know, we don't understand that even sometimes music can play a role to bring you back into maybe entertaining some bad thoughts. And so being raised with godly parents does influence you. And oftentimes, my testimony is not very glamorous, not very Hollywood. Raised with good parents.
Amen.
And at a very young age, I still needed the same Savior as everybody else.
That's right.
That
That's
same
right.
Savior, that biker that is in prison, I still needed that same God as he.
That's right.